Hey everyone, welcome to Simple Backups. In this video, we're going to create a files backup and a database backup. Let's start by creating our files backup. To create your files backup, connect to your server. You can choose one of three options to connect your server. We're going to use the automated method to connect it. All you need to do is copy the command SSH to your server's terminal and paste it in. This is going to run our connection script, which is going to connect your server to Simple Backups. Once the command has run successfully, click on validate, and then the server will appear in your Simple Backups account. After that, you need to define your file path, and if you have any exploited file path, you can enter that as well. Now, we can go ahead and name our backup and choose our retention and schedule. I'm going to choose a retention of 5 and keep it on a daily backup. For your storage, you can bring your own storage. We have a variety of storage options, or you can choose Simple Storage, which is our proprietary storage solution. Once the backup job has been created, let's click on Run Now to test our backup. As you can see, we have a status indicator indicating that the backup is currently running. We can go ahead and view our real-time output, and we can also view our console output. This is useful for when you need to debug your backups. Once the backup has been finished, you can see that the indicator has changed to success. You will also be able to view the restore tab, which is going to have your signed download links. You'll also be able to view the instructions on how to restore your backups. Let's move on to creating our own database backup. I have a database hosted on my own server that we've just backed up. So I can go ahead and select own server, select the server we have just added, and I'm going to enter my database username and password. Let's load our databases. Okay, I'm going to select my application database and go ahead and validate the connection. Once my database connection has been validated, let's choose a name for my database backup. And then we can choose our schedule, our retention, and our storage. Click on Create Backup, and let's trigger our first backup for our database to validate that it's working. And you can see the status indicator right then. It will change to success once the backup is done. Once the backup is done, we can go to the Restore tab and view a preferred method of restoring the database backup. We have an automated restore option, we have a planet-scale restore option, and the manual restore option. You can also view logs, and you can select which backup you want to restore for up to the retention limit you've selected in your backup. In your dashboard, you'll be able to see all of your backups, and you'll get a quick glance of your backup statuses.